Hello everyone and welcome to a new ride overview. In this video, the stand-up coaster is in the spotlight, as requested by Nightlife Sucks and Robert Rowley. It is famous for having some of the worst stats in the game, and even though that's very much true, it is also one of my favorite coaster types. I really like the track design and I consider getting good stats on it a nice challenge. If you have access to the Corkscrew coaster, then there really isn't any reason to use the stand-up coaster, as the Corkscrew coaster is the same with better stats and also has boosters and a launched mode. The cars for the stand-up coaster are fairly short, meaning you don't need a long station to fit 2 6-car trains, which is a slight advantage. The main reason I still often use the stand-up is because its track design looks so good. As you will see when we look at some designs, having the intensity 4 or even 5 points higher than the excitement rating is more a rule than an exception. Getting over 6 excitement in a short and compact design is very difficult if you don't include decorations. However, despite these terrible stats, is it not impossible to get over 10 excitement, although it is very difficult. When designing a stand-up coaster, you generally want to take inversions at very slow speeds because it gets a lot of intensity from high G-forces. A lot of other coasters get intensity from G-forces easily as well, but it is much less noticeable because their intensity stats are much lower for the same design. To illustrate the impact of lowering G-forces, here is a design with 10 inversions that still has below 10 intensity because it has very low G-forces. This isn't a good design, so don't use it, but it does show that lowering G-forces is very important on the stand-up coaster. Now that we've discussed the basics, let's take a look at the special elements it has to offer. It has the standard station, brakes, block brakes, photo section and S-bends, and the slightly less common small and big spirals. The other special elements are 3 different types of inversions: the vertical loop, the half loop and the corkscrew. Up next are the stat penalties. The stand-up coaster is very straightforward when it comes to this. It needs a drop of at least 9 meters, it needs to have a top speed of at least 36 km per hour, and it needs to have at least 0.50 negative Gs. That last one is completely useless, as you already get a maximum of 0.49 negative Gs when you build a design without any hills, like this. It is impossible to fill this requirement, but it is in there anyway. Now the time has come to look at some designs with the worst stats so far, and they'll likely only be overtaken when I do the hardline coaster overview. This first one is the small design, which is the only design that manages to have the intensity less than 3 points higher than the excitement. You can pick between 2 variants. The one with the corkscrew is slightly more expensive, but you get higher stats and you can build path under the corkscrew. The small turn design is the absolute cheapest design. I would recommend using the corkscrew design most of the time. The second design is the short and intense design I like to do, and you can see that in the stats. It has a massive 5.02 difference between the intensity rating and excitement rating. This is mainly due to the high G-forces I talked about earlier. That said, the intensity does make it so that you can charge a higher price for the ride, so it's not completely useless. Up next is a slightly smaller design that has a smaller difference between the intensity and excitement rating. This one also only takes up 60% of the area that the previous one uses. It does come at the cost of a slightly lower excitement rating, but I think this design is better than the previous, mainly due to its smaller size. The fourth design is another long and slim design that is very similar to the second coaster, but goes back and forth one extra time. It also has lower G-forces, resulting in a slightly lower intensity rating despite having an extra inversion and 2 more drops. The S-turns going through the vertical loops is a neat trick that I learned on Reddit that can help you make narrow designs like this one. The last design is the only one that reaches 6 excitement without decorations, and only because it has interlocking loops. It is also exactly 600 meters long, meaning it works in harder gas generation scenarios. I really like this design. It's compact and has a good excitement to intensity ratio for the stand-up coaster, and it looks cool. This design is great if you want to make the most money with the stand-up without having very expensive coasters. In conclusion, the stand-up coaster has some of the worst stats in the game and is generally just a worse corkscrew coaster. However, it is far from the worst coaster type, as it does have access to quite a few different special elements. If you want to use the designs, a zip file with them is in the description. A calculator that you can use to determine how much you can charge for each of these designs is also in the description. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video.